Good evening and welcome to Fat Pigeon Live. And my name's Duffy.
And my name's Holly Willoughby.
But sometimes we call him Sam. And welcome to another live streaming session. Once again, we're at one of our favourite, incredible music venues.
We are at Biddulph Up in Arms in St Lawrence's Church.
So don't forget to share,
like and subscribe.
Yeah, and don't forget to send in your comments. We like to hear those. And now we're going over to the stage where Craig Pickering is going to tell us who's on tonight.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the wonderful surroundings of St Lawrence's Church. Packed again, so we'll just tell you where the toilets are in the foyer there as you came in. We've got a fire exit through the vestry here. And Simon at the back, wave to Simon there. We're going to open those big double doors if we need to get out really quickly. We've got a fantastic night for you, but this is very much a family affair. So sitting here very nervously, waiting to make her stage debut, give her a big welcome, Ella Dixon-Hood.
Thank you. This next song I'm going to sing for you is another cover, and it's by Billie Eilish, who's a young singer, and she's killing it at the moment. But it's called When the Party's Over. This next song I'm going to sing for you is an original. So yeah, I hope you like it. My way. smile. Hell, I even held my head up for a while. Told everyone we're okay. But we're back to where we started. A crippled mind and broken hearted is rolling like a river down my eyes. And I don't want to talk about it. We've been here a thousand times before. I'm not playing these games anymore. Next one I'm going to do for you is there's loads of covers about it, but I'm going to do the legend of Johnny Cash's version. It's called Wayfaring Stranger.
I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger traveling through this world below. There is no sickness, no toil, no danger in that bright land to which I go. I'm going there to see my father and all the loved ones who've gone on. I'm just going over Jordan. I'm just going over home. I know dark clouds will gather round me. I know my way is holding steep, but beauteous fields arise before me. Where God redeems every Jew's keep. I'm going there to see my mother. She said she'd meet me when I come. And I'm just going over Jordan. I'm just going over home. I'm just going Jordan. I'm just going over home.
I'm going to play another one of mine. And it's actually one of my newest ones, although they are all new to you tonight. Yes, it's untitled at the moment, so if anyone has any names for this song, I'll appreciate it.
Missing you, oh hey. Too easy. I don't know which is worse, but loving you so deeply. So much trouble, you cause me so much pain. You ask me what I'm doing. I could ask you the same.
Thank you. this next one is another cover, and it's from the series Nashville. I don't know if any of you have watched it or heard of it. But yeah, it's called Sanctuary.
Turn the light off, come to bed. Tell me all about the day you had. Lay beside me, it's time to rest. You can close your eyes, you've done your best.
I'm on my last two songs now, and I just want to say a massive thank you for everyone for listening, as it is my first gig, and you've been lovely. And also to Megan for having me as her support act. That's what sisters are there for. For this next one, I'm going to switch up for a bit, and I'm going to ask the wonderful Liam if he can play guitar for me. yeah, this is by another cover, and it's by Missy Higgins, and it's called Secret.
We were from the north, I was from the south. We were from opposite places and different towns. But I knew it was good and you knew it was too. So we moved together like a ball and chain. Minds becoming two halves of the same. It was real, but in the shadows it grew. You got a secret, don't you, babe? I would have shouted loud, broken through. I would have given it all to belong to you. But there were different plays and different rules. You say, where I'm from is a lock and key. If you'll be so kind as to follow me, I will show you the way to the rest of my sins. You got a secret, don't you, babe? You got a secret, don't you, babe? I should.
Is my last one, and it's going to be a cappella, hopefully. No, it will. it's from, again, from the Nashville series, but it's actually played on guitar. I'm just going to switch up for you.
Some nights I don't sleep at all. I lie awake with my eyes closed. Some nights I'm inside a cloud, so tired I just float around, and I'm lost again. I'm lost too far from you. And I thought time would fade, your face was sure that others could erase what my heart felt so deep. Is bronze now, I don't know what's going on, and I'm lost again. I'm lost too far from you, too far from the body of water, too far from the sounds that kept me dancing around. And it's the kind that cannot break all this time. I still can shake one moment that we knew is waiting, could not let it slip away, and I'm lost
Fantastic. Fantastic. What do you reckon, Sam?
That was incredible, yeah.
What do you reckon, Megan?
Brilliant.
I'm so proud. Oh, she's amazing.
Why? What's she got to do with you?
Because she's my little sister.
That's your little sister?
Yeah, it's my little sister, yeah. And she's just an amazing. It's her first ever show.
First ever show.
Yeah, she didn't actually realise, did she, that anyone's going to be here recording?
How do you think she did? Come on, honestly.
She's literally incredible. I knew how nervous she was before she came on. And she smashed it.
Were you
so
quite
proud.
Nervous too?
I'm nervous now.
That's what I mean. Were you nervous for her?
Yeah. A little bit. But I knew she'd do it. But now I'm more nervous to go on after she's played.
Very good. Oh, we ought to say who you are, really. We've just said, hello, Megan. What did you think? Oh, it's my sister. This is Megan Dixon Hood. She's on in a minute. Yeah. With a band. And a string quartet as well.
Yes, a string quartet too.
The difference, isn't there?
Yeah. Just to mix it up, you know, yeah. Be fresh. Yeah.
So tell us all about why you're here tonight in particular with your band and the string quartet.
Because we're about to release a new EP called Tales from the North, and we wanted to celebrate the release. So the band and I have come together with the string quartet from the Untold Orchestra. And yeah, we just wanted to celebrate releasing the EP, so it's exciting. It's
so,
really
new
exciting.
EP, what's it called?
It's called Tales from the North.
Oh, right, from the North Country.
From the North.
Oh, right. You come from the North Country, lad.
Could do.
For the sake of tonight.
Yeah, for the sake of tonight, I'll be on your side.
Be careful here, yeah. We're sort of almost in the North here, aren't we, really?
Almost.
Technically speaking,
not
fast, yeah.
You know, so, close enough.
Why Tales from the North? What's the idea of that?
A lot of the songs on the EP are stories, they're tales, and some of them actually are like folk tales based in the North. And well, I'm sort of from the North, so I feel like it made sense. Yeah.
Yeah. Great. Well, I've sort of know it a bit. I have actually heard some of the
songs. You've heard some of it, yeah.
And they're great.
Thank
fantastic.
You.
I think there's a little bit of a change in musical direction. A little
possibly.
Bit, would you say that?
Yeah. Possibly.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's still you, and it's still that great sound and that great voice. But I think there's something. New happening.
There's a bit of
behind
it.
I don't know.
A bit more
up. Yeah, a bit more up. Let's put it that way. Yeah.
What's the strings?
Got to get this right. People might not wear. So when's it actually coming out? Is it now?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Okay.
Yes. If you're here tonight, then the CDs are available, but it's tomorrow. Right.
So tomorrow, if you're listening to this in a recorded fashion, or watching it as well, then we've no idea when it was released, because it depends on when you were listening to it, really, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But if you're listening to it live, then it's Saturday.
The 1st
it will
of December,
be coming out.
Yeah.
And that means it's perfectly in time for Christmas. How about that?
I thought it through, didn't I?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, I see where you're
some thought
from.
Process in there, isn't there? Something like that.
So does it go really far north, like Lapland, you know?
Yeah, basically.
Is there a Christmas song?
It's all winter-related, yeah. No, not quite a Christmas song, but...
Well, really. Sorry. Anyway, you've got to go and do some work in a minute.
I do, yes. I better actually get on
stage. You're going to do two sets, aren't you?
We are, yes.
Yeah, yeah. And we're going to try and find your sister, if you see her anywhere.
I want to go give her a big hug and say well done.
And then you can send her over here and we might be able to
I'll go and grab her, yeah.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
No, thank you.
Thank you, and good luck.
Thank you.
We'll see you and we'll hear you and see you and everything in a bit. Very soon.
Thank you so much.
Go and knock them dead.
Where is she?
I think she walked straight past her.
Oh, she's just gone. Oh, never mind. It's all right. This is seamless, this show. Seamless.
Completely, always, but, always.
Yes, please. Craig's going to get Ella for us. Yeah. Ella, come over here.
You're doing all right.
Come over. You have
been
to. You have to talk.
And all. Yeah,
have you ever used one of these things before? If you come and stand there and look over there.
Oh, okay.
And it's all very confusing. Sort of back to front, really, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, well, that was a fantastic set.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for
well
that.
Well done, yeah.
Yeah. Thanks. We should be thanking you, isn't that true? Yeah. Not the other way around. So, Ella Cicely.
Yes.
Are you trying to hide the Megan Dixon, the Dixon Hood bit?
I mean, I just don't want to be like associated with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I wouldn't be.
I want my own little
with
space.
With your own sister,
I
yeah.
I
no, yeah, get rid of
that yeah, one. Yeah. You, yeah.
No, so I thought, well, I better change it up. Couldn't really have just the one Ella Dixon. So I thought I'd just choose the middle name. I'll be fine.
It is your middle name.
It is my middle
I
name.
I guess that. Yeah, I thought it might be. Yeah. Yeah. So first, in front of an audience or first proper in front of an audience?
First, sort of... So I've done like school stuff, but that's nothing, is it really?
Well, also when you've got cameras and everything.
Yeah,
so right. You didn't realise there were cameras,
lights,
did you?
Lights.
In the deep end there.
Yes.
There's a million people watching you out there. There's only about 150.
Yeah, all of a sudden,
no
like,
pressure.
Nice.
But you told me that after I've done my No, it was really fun actually. I did enjoy it.
Yeah, well, you look good up there and you're sounding good.
Thanks. Thank you.
Yeah. You seem actually really chilled.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm glad that came across.
Came across. You not, no.
No.
We were all
that's
scared to
halfway.
Point, you know.
Yeah.
So, songwriting, obviously you did some nice, beautiful covers there, but there was, four songs that you wrote yourself?
Two of my own, and the rest
one
of
that's
covers.
Yet to be titled, I'm guessing, as
yes.
well.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I've still not got a name for it, it's just untitled.
Maybe if you've heard that song, or watched that song, called Untitled, then you might be able to send a comment in and maybe help Cicely out.
You're now everyone.
Ella. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Everyone will be.
You will keep changing your name. Go.
It's all right. Don't worry. I'll take it.
Yeah. So, but it can be anything at all. We don't. She doesn't have to use it. You know, that's the thing. But you might be.
No, I probably will figure out one.
So anyway, what was the motives behind these songs? What's provoked you to make? Because there's some heartfelt stuff in there as well. Is that just
as in my own or other people's?
Well, your own stuff, because even in those, it's. Was there any stuff that you can't really explain?
Yeah, kind of.
So someone out there, whoever's watching anywhere, will know exactly what those songs are about.
You know who you are.
You need a lot of help with these. I can see this. Yeah.
So, ouch, so,
what
damn.
What about writing influences then?
I listen to a lot of Johnny Cash. And who else do I listen to? I listen to a mix of people. I don't really like sticking into one category.
Nope.
Although I would say my own like performance sort of thing, and it's more like bluesy country.
Come around this way, sir. That's all right.
He's got beer.
It's all very. We like people to do that. Yes.
Nice. You
didn't buy me a drink.
Yeah. Save the pint.
Sorry, you were saying.
Yeah. So I just like, I don't know, country sort of music, and I think the way they write their songs is more interesting than what's out there.
Yeah.
Sort of thing.
Yeah. But a lot of songwriters have said to me that, as far as not their style, but the way they write, the influences are very varied, because that's the whole point. Because you take things from different genres, different ideas, different styles, everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and they probably did too, all the other songwriters.
Yeah.
The same thing.
I mean,
so it goes on.
Yeah, I mean, I do write differently than Megan. Megan and I have tried writing, and like, it is kind of different the way we work.
Yeah, would you ever sing together or play together? Or?
I wouldn't ever not do it. I mean, we do it in the house quite often. It's just.
Just
doing
ending
it
up
the privacy of your own house.
Yeah, yeah.
But you prefer to be separate entities.
I'd like to be separate identities, but I don't mind doing like, should we do a one-off and just do?
It turned out like The Sound of Music or something.
No,
like that,
yeah. Although that film is great.
Or The Osmonds. Or...
No, not planning on doing.
I'm trying to think of a girl band that's sisters. There's loads. Yeah.
First Aid Kit's a good one.
Oh, are they?
Which Megan and I do listen to a lot.
Yeah.
So maybe they're a bit of an influence. I don't know.
Right. I was going to say the Andrews Sisters. Have you heard of them, Sam?
No.
Have you not? Have you heard of them?
No, I don't think.
But we used to listen to them in the war.
Right.
The Second World War. That was.
Okay. Yeah, just correct that. It's Second World.
Oh, they're very good. And the Beverly Sisters. I'm not getting anywhere with these, am I?
We'll just nod and smile.
Yeah.
And go, yeah.
Okay.
We know exactly who they are. Yeah. It's cool.
Anyway, Ella, thank you very much
for
coming to chat with us. It's just after you.
And well done, more importantly.
Cheers,
it was
thank
good.
You.
Yeah.
Thank
well, you can't take that away with you, though. It's,
no.
We've only got three.
Go and get yourself a drink.
Thank you, I will.
Okay. Right, well, we're gonna see how they're getting on setting up. We're gonna put the cameras on the setup and see how interesting it is. And I don't think it'll be very long before we get to, I think they've probably gone already.
I think we've got a sister on the way up, and I think it's going to be a bit more punchy. Lush.
I'll be back here.
Hello, welcome back, everybody. Wasn't Ella great? Give another big round of applause for Ella. Now, this is a big show, but it all started several years back when Through My Front Door posted two EPs beautifully tied with a ribbon. And I still don't know who posted those CDs, but whoever it was, huge thanks. Introducing me to this young lady's music. She's surely a star of the future. Please give her a huge welcome with the band Megan Dixon Hood.
Thank you.
mountaintop, dusted and white, no river flows. Only echoes of the voices left behind. No traveler returns, no man in sight. Fall, fall down. Fall, fall down. It is bleak and it is bad and it is desolate. It is bleak and it is bad and it is desolate. In this sea of ice,
for coming out. We're gonna play you some songs from my new EP. It's gonna run, there's gonna be two sets tonight, so we're gonna play a first set for you, and then there's gonna be an interval, and then we're gonna come back on and do a set with the band and the Untold Orchestra string quartet, so it's really exciting. And we're gonna play an older song for you now, so some of you might know this one, and this is Siren.
She is a gatherer of golden. that she guards from the blackest night. She is a traveler of forgotten time. Gentle eyes that stop these vicious tides.
I hope that a lot of you already know that my songs are very melancholy, so I apologise in advance. But I like to write about stories and things that I've read. And this next one is actually about a play I read in school called The Crucible. And I have some friends in here from school, and they probably think I'm really weird that I wanted to write about GCSE textbooks. But it's a really interesting story. And for anyone who doesn't know, it's actually based on a true story hundreds of years ago in Salem, and it's about the witch trials there. And then there's this particular protagonist who sort of set it all off, and a lot of innocent people were accused of being witches and murdered. And I thought, what a great song choice. So, yeah, as you do. So, yeah, this is about the protagonist, and this is called Abigail.
One night we took possession of the woods, troubled by the spirits up above. And I say you worship the devil, and I say you worship the devil. No ring on my finger, so you cast me aside. These rules you have made, well, I will not abide. And I say you worship the devil. Come running, running.
playing my thoughts to the bitter ending. I'm just seeking our revenge. You playing my thoughts to the bitter ending. I will lead you to despair. If you call, I'll come running, I'll be there. If you call, I'll come running, I'll be there. Hey, when you call, I will come running, 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 running. When you call, I will come running, 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 running. When you call, I will come running. When you call, I will come running. When you call, I will come running. When you
I want to give a massive round of applause to Ella. Like, she's amazing. She has never, ever, ever played a gig in her life. And I was like, it'll just be a few people if you just come down. And there's not all these cameras and lights and stuff. But she's incredible. So I'm so proud of her. Thank you. She also, I should give her a mention, actually. The CDs that we have here tonight, the new one, she actually helped me design the whole thing, so she's like double talented. So yeah, if you get a chance to have a look, she helped me. It turns out I have terrible skills in Photoshop, and I just was like, please help me. So yeah, she's helped make the EP, so thank you so much. I don't know where she is, but thank you so much. But yeah, can you give a round of applause? To break it up a little bit, we're going to play something a little bit fun. And this is called A Year From Now.
Things will be deferred.
things will be different a year from now. And things will be different a year from now. Try something so new that we only finished it yesterday, but so bear with us if it all goes terribly wrong. It's actually a song I've written recently, and it's quite close to me because I believe that there is no planet B and that we should really take care of the one that we're already on. And the story, it's called The Wishing Tree, and it's basically about how we look to like Mother Earth and particular wish with wishing trees, you know, you're asking for something from a tree. And yet we continue to destroy them and the things around them. So it's a little bit political, but it means a lot to me. So I really want to try this out, so please bear with us. But this is called The Wishing Tree.
Me to the wishing tree, where I shall make a wish or three. For I am weary of this world. I offer up this gift to you, a token of my gratitude. If only you could make dreams true. give you air, but you did not even seem to care. Go on, take what you want from me. Go on, take what you want from me. Go on, take what you want from me. Go on, take what you want from me.
Song left for you for now, and I'm going to take a short break, so get yourself some more drinks. There are CDs over there if you want to have a little look. But yeah, we're going to play one more song for you, and then we'll be back on in about 15, 20 minutes, I think. I'm so unfit. Seeing as it's winter, this is the right time of year, and the next song I'm going to play for you is actually new as well. And this is about the Festival of Light. I believe it's in Sweden. And they sort of look up, they have this festival of light every year. I think it's at the winter solstice. And again, what a great song content. Yeah, so this is called Saint Lucia.
There's a long ahead of us, cold enough for the trees to shiver and the sun to grow weary and the moon to shimmer. There's a sleeping forest, a silent wood hidden in a sheet of white, its crystal underfoot, a blanket of snow. Thank you. gown, candles lit upon a silver crown, made from ribbons and frosty branches are watching us.
Pretty good, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was
wicked.
Yeah, what do you think, Sam? It was incredible. I'm literally gobsmacked every time I hear her. She's absolutely brilliant. The whole band is. It's a pleasure to watch.
And what do you reckon, Sam?
I think she's brilliant. It's like beautiful tunes. Yeah.
Fantastic, isn't it? Yeah. There's two Sams here now. Yeah. We, you know that Sam over there.
Unfortunately.
This is the other Sam. This is Sam Davis.
Hello.
Yeah. Now, I better explain why he's here. What would you say your role is? In charge of?
I'm
director
kind
of.
The founder, the director, the arranger, the fixer for the Untold Orchestra.
The Untold Orchestra,
yeah.
Which you may have heard mentioned once or twice already. You haven't seen them yet because they're on in the next half of Megan Dixon's set. So you are the founder, arranger, director. You've got to be the director.
All
as well,
of it, pretty
surely.
Much, yeah, all of
the main
it.
Man.
Band manager.
A little bit, yeah.
Okay. So what's it all about then?
The Untold Orchestra is a Manchester-based orchestra, and basically we look to bring the music of up-and-coming artists to life by adding string sections to 15-piece to 40-piece orchestras and really giving really talented musicians like Megan opportunities to hear their music played by an orchestra.
Wow.
Yeah. So sort of taking it to like an ELO and sort of things
like
that.
Yeah, taking it to a bigger level and trying to not do it, you know, not with these big artists, but with these up-and-coming artists that have got amazing tunes.
So what a fantastic idea, but this is a delicate subject really, but it's like the reason most up-and-coming artists don't have a big orchestra is because they can't afford to, right? So how does it work?
So artists do pay towards the projects that we do,
okay.
But we try and share the cost between bands. So we might record 4 or 5 bands a day. Back to back, we did a project in March where we had 9 bands over 2 weekends recording 14 songs, and that went from a kora player to a jazz quintet to a rock band.
Wow.
And that basically kind of takes the burden off paying for a whole day of an orchestra and sharing it with all these different artists, and really builds a bit of excitement through these artists, how they can each help each other reach their fan bases and stuff.
So is that mainly for a live set up, a live gig, or are you recording?
Yeah, you're recording.
So the focus for the last year has been recording. So we've recorded 20 bands in the last year. 2019 is all about live. So we're going into the live circuit a bit more next year, doing original projects of our own music, doing covers stuff, and then trying to work with artists like Meg, bringing an orchestra to more and more people, really.
How large is your actual orchestra then? How many people do you have? Anyone give time if you can?
There we go. The biggest we've had has been 40. But most our projects tend to be between 15 and 20 players in the orchestra.
Wicked.
Yeah.
That's really.
So how would somebody with a band watching right now, how would they go about
getting
maybe
in touch?
Maybe, possibly.
Getting in touch and making their band bigger
just,
and whatnot.
You can search us on Facebook, The Untold Orchestra. Send us a message there. You can visit our website, which is just theuntoldorchestra.com, and just get in touch, send some of your songs over, start the ball, have the conversation, and see what happens, really.
Because obviously, it's not going to be right for everybody, or you might not consider it to be right to be part of everything.
Yeah, although what I would say is that at first I thought only certain types of music it would work with, but the more projects we do, we've done stuff with so many different genres, and actually there's always a way of making it work, and that then becomes a challenge for the arranging team to have to make it work.
So if you get a call tomorrow, say for instance this guy who's got a band, they've never played in public before, they usually do their stuff in their bedroom, they'd like a 40-piece orchestra, how would you tackle that?
But no.
It could be a big bedroom. I don't know.
We'll see.
Hypothetically.
Send some songs over.
But you haven't
we'll
said
see.
No.
I haven't
see?
Said no.
That's
no.
Brilliant. Yeah.
No, we want to make it an opportunity for as many people as possible. Yeah. I think
fantastic.
For a long time, the orchestra world has been a distant thing for a lot of people, both musicians and audiences alike. Yeah, yeah. So we want to try and find a way of bringing that to more and more people.
I think that's brilliant. So tonight, it's only a quartet, which I believe is four people.
Yeah, four string players
tonight, Did you know that?
I did know that, actually, yeah. Okay. Unlike the other comments earlier.
Yeah, he was looking it up as well.
Okay.
Yeah. So, who have we got? Who have we got tonight?
So, our players tonight, all graduates from the Royal Norman College of Music in Manchester, which is where most of our orchestral players come from. So, we've got Heather McLeod on first violin. We've got Elia Harris on second violin, Sophia Dignam on viola, and Ellie Boney on cello. And actually, Heather, the first violinist, her boyfriend is also James, who's doing the sound tonight as well.
Oh, right. See, I've been working with James all day. Really.
Yeah, so the first violinist is his girlfriend.
No. Yeah. Well, lucky man. Lucky man.
Yeah.
Lucky girl.
Yeah. You've got a free sound engineer.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah.
The strings will be coming on, but I'm going to start on my own, if that's okay. And I really want to play a cover for you that some of you might know. And it's called Woodstock by Joni Mitchell. And I just love how the song is. It's about bringing everyone together in music, and that's what's happened tonight. So this is my version of Woodstock. Hope you enjoy it.
I came upon a child of God. He was walking along the road. I asked him, "Where are you going?" And this he told me. He said, "I'm going on down to Yasgur's farm. I'm gonna join in a rock and roll to get us
I have some very special guests. So a little while ago, in September, we recorded Wolves and Drown, and they're actually on the new EP, with an 18-piece orchestra, the Untold Orchestra, and it was the best experience ever. It was so cool. And so we asked if the string quartet, we've narrowed it down a little bit, would come down tonight and play for the second set. So please give a warm welcome to the string quartet for tonight. We actually filmed the videos as well, the songs that are on the EP. So currently Drown is out. If you want to catch that one, it's all on YouTube and you can see us all in action. But yeah, we're going to add a few more songs tonight. The first one we're actually going to do for you is an old song. And some of you might know this, because this is going to be Early Morning Riser.
You rise where the soul
And so now it gets even more exciting because I'm going to welcome the band back on. And when they come to the stage, Mr. Drake Gebel on drums, Liam Morgan on guitar, and Mr. Jake Steele on bass. Song we're going to play for you is the one that you can actually view live on YouTube, and it's on the CD. And this is another sad folk tale story. I'm really sorry. The title gives it away a bit, but this is about a girl who drowns. No! you. Thank you so much. This is another fun one for you. This girl is accused of murder and locked away for a very long time. It's about a book I read called Alias Grace by Margaret Atwood, which is a very good book, actually. And again, it's based on true events. I don't know how I keep finding these things, but it's an interesting read. And this is Alias Grace.
Quiet now, don't you wake the beast. You could never speak in silent tongues. Choose not to care, or maybe you just choose not to care, but I can hear you. You want me to hear you.
CDs before, maybe even bought them.
there's a lot of artwork in it. There's a lyric booklet inside and the front cover. And I just want to thank my dad because he painted all the artwork inside there, and the front cover is my favourite piece of artwork of his. So, Dad, thanks so much. And he also helped organise today, along with Craig, who's like the best promoter ever. So this wouldn't have happened without them both. So thank you so much. And this next song is arguably one of our favourite ones to play. And this is called Walls.
She yells like the wind as she holds on to the moon. She could run with the wolves, but she won't be coming home soon. She could cry like the rain, but those tears won't be for you. Could run with the wolves, but she won't be coming home soon. Coming home soon. Coming home soon.
I can't see anything. We actually only have one song left now, but if you cheer really loud after, we might play you one more song. I'm scared to walk off and do an encore and then you don't call us back on, so we'll just stay on stage. thank you so much to everyone who's come down. I literally can't believe that you're all here. This is amazing. So thank you so much. Thank you to Craig for organising it all. Thank you for Fat Pigeon for streaming everything, which is so amazing. Thank you so much to Sam Davies, who is in the room tonight, because he arranged all the string for this evening and for the orchestra thing. So thank you so much to him as well. Thank you so much to the string players themselves, because they're amazing. And my band also, who are equally amazing. And thanks to my mum and dad, for having me so that I could be here tonight, and also for letting us rehearse at late nights in the living room. I really appreciate it. And mum, thanks for feeding us in between. thank you so much for coming. This is our final song, and this is called With Time. Thank you.
my heart is breaking. With time, time.
This at all. So we're going to have one more special guest of the evening, and it's Mr. Sam Davies himself who arranged all the string music. So please give him a round of applause. He's going to come play some keys.
Well, I think you're crazy.
Wasn't that amazing? Come on, give it up! Two very proud parents, I'm sure, Mel and Jilly Hood. And we must mention St. Lawrence's Church. They've given us a new breath of life, really, after the pub closed, and allowing us to use every bit of available space and put a bar in here. So St. Lawrence's Church, thank you very, very much. One more time for Ella Dixon Hood. Megan Dixon Hood. And the Untold Orchestra.